Blackmagic Camera 3.2 just dropped with full support for live streaming to YouTube, Twitch, and Vimeo. So now on both iPhone and Android, we have a robust live streaming solution that is completely free. My name's Elliot, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to go live to Twitch and YouTube, answer the most frequently asked questions about live streaming in Blackmagic Camera, and share 8 key findings that you need to know before you go live to avoid a streaming disaster. Remember, there are chapters built into the player so you can find exactly what you're looking for. And let's start by selecting our platform and finding our stream key so we can go live on YouTube. If you're brand new to live streaming, the Livestream platform is simply the platform you are broadcasting to. To select one, open Settings, Livestream, and tap on Platform. Here we can select one of 4 supported platforms. Let's start with YouTube, then tap back. Next, we need to enter our stream key for our selected platform. A stream key is a unique code that links your broadcasting app, which is Blackmagic Camera, to your live streaming platform, which is currently YouTube. To get your YouTube stream key in your browser, go to studio.youtube.com and log into your account. If you're trying to access this page on mobile using Safari or Chrome, make sure you request the desktop version of the site first, then click the Go Live button. This is where we can give our stream a title and set its visibility, but what we want is the stream key, which is found under the stream settings. Your stream key should never be shared with anyone, which is why it's hidden by default. If you had my stream key, you could go live on my YouTube channel. Tap to copy it and return to Blackmagic Camera. Then tap on key and paste it here. Lastly, set your streaming quality to low, medium, or high depending on your upload bandwidth speed. I'll choose high. Now, to start my live stream, I simply enable live stream. We are automatically returned to the camera. We can see that we are on air, view our live duration, as well as our current upload speed. And if we return to our YouTube studio, we can see that we have successfully gone live. If you want to end your live stream in Blackmagic Camera, simply tap Live Streaming in the HUD and disable the live stream. Next, let's look at how to go live in Twitch. Tap on Settings, select Live Stream, and then under Platform, select Twitch. To find your Twitch stream key, go to dashboard.twitch.tv in your browser, and if trying to access this on a mobile device, ensure you request the desktop site, as the dashboard is designed for desktop only. Select Settings, Stream, and copy your primary stream key from here. Return to Blackmagic Camera and paste it under Key. Then enable live stream, and after a few seconds from your Twitch dashboard, you should see that you are successfully live streaming to Twitch. Now I'll answer the most frequently asked questions about live streaming in Blackmagic Camera on iPhone and Android, starting with, do I need to enter my stream key each time I go live? No, you don't. Blackmagic will remember your stream key across platforms, so you only need to enter it once, and it will be saved for future live streams. Can I record locally on my device while live streaming? Yes, you absolutely can. Simply enable your live stream, and then it is as simple as hitting the record button from the camera. Now you'll have a high quality local version of your stream, ideal for grading and editing. Can I use LUTs while live streaming? Absolutely, but you need to be aware that currently display LUTs will not be output to your live stream. If you're recording in Apple Log or Samsung Log and enable a display LUT, your live stream is still being broadcast in Log. To apply a LUT to your live stream, you have to enable Record LUT to Clip. Only then is it applied to your stream, even if you're not recording internally. This implementation isn't great. It means you can't record locally in Apple Log while live streaming with a LUT applied to give you a Rec. 709 image for your stream. Hopefully Blackmagic addresses this in a future update. Does lens switching work while live? Yes, it does. While live, you can use the lens picker to change lenses and it won't disrupt your stream. It works with all real lenses as well as your selfie lens too. Can I zoom while going live? Yes, you can apply digital zoom during a live stream. You can either pinch to zoom in and out or tap on the lens button and apply your zoom from here. Can I change orientation while live? No. You need to decide on your aspect ratio before going live, as you cannot switch between portrait and landscape once you enable a live stream. Does my capture frame rate apply to my live stream? No, it doesn't. Based on my testing, currently your live stream's frame rate is locked to 30 frames per second. It doesn't matter what your frame rate is set to in Blackmagic Camera. For example, when set to 24 FPS, only the internal capture is at 24 FPS. The live stream is at 30 FPS. This means currently there is no 60 FPS live streaming in Blackmagic Camera. Can I live stream in HDR from Blackmagic Camera? Not right now. Even when your color space is set to Rec 2020 HDR, only your local recording is in HDR. Based on my testing, even after processing is complete on YouTube, the live stream is not HDR, but washed out SDR. I would recommend you do not use Rec 2020 for live streaming as a result. So there you have it, live streaming to YouTube and Twitch in Blackmagic Camera on both iOS and Android. If this video helped, please like and subscribe and consider supporting the channel by becoming a member. Any questions, just ask in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.